Now here's a motorbike trip I've always wanted to do. From Sen Monorom to Banlung in Ratanakere. It's like going all the way from South Wales to North Wales and across similar terrain.
Time to check out and head off. Now it's easy road to Banlung. Just one road, just follow it. There's no fuel stops after 80 clicks. I'll just head back, but should be okay. If you're planning on doing this journey between December and February, dress up warm because the mornings in the mountains are freezing. Seem to be small villages every 10 clicks, so it's enough to stock up with the water and fuel.
That wind chill just bites straight through you.
It's a great driving road.
The temperature has reached 20 Celsius or 68 Fahrenheit, so it's starting to become comfortable.
I've reached the small market village of Cognier, where there's even a guest house and there's plenty of edible food and drink. Just a couple of clicks into Ratanakere, I've broken down right in the middle of the Lumpat Wildlife Reserve. Looks like I got plenty of fuel in there. So it's this old electrical problem come back. Oh well. Couldn't be in a more remote place on earth. Now it's always good to carry a screwdriver with you in case there's some kind of petrol problem, and then you can just drain out the carb here. Judging by the vapor coming off of that, it seems not to be water but fuel, so switch off the ignition and start stripping this wire down. So I've managed to cut down this HT lead to expose some fresh copper. Now I'll see if that works, and then we'll connect it up with some rubber tape and a girly scrungie I found at the side of the road. So, I mean, I wouldn't have that sort of thing with me. Oh, bollocks. Well, I don't know what's up north, but it's only a couple of miles down back to the county border. I think there were a few small roadside stores there, see what they can do. Prepared with a spare bottle of water just in case. Some of these controlled forest fires here are really fragrant. Like sandalwood. It's getting easier to push now, so I think we're coming to a downhill where I could ride this for a little bit. Oh, looks like I got 60% of the way there. Wonder what this small hamlet is here at the bottom of this slope. Oh, I don't think this mad dog and a few chickens are going to be any help. The next house looks a bit more hopeful. Well, fortunately, this house here sells petrol and drinking water, so I can work here in the shade for a while, see if I can get back on the road again. Well, I'm in a better position than I was just half an hour ago. Look at this lady here, eking out a living by picking up cans and bottles thrown out of the window on this remote country lane through the Lumpat National Park. Oh, let's see. Well, it seems to have come back to life now. Oh yeah, it's all very funny to them. It's always amazing, just when you think you're in the remotest place on earth, you meet people who call this home. Decided not to be stingy anymore and get a proper mechanic to fix it, and the exhaust is blowing as well. So I can get a new HT lead, new spark plug, a new connector from the HT lead to the spark plug, and a new exhaust pipe, all for about 16 bucks. Why was I so stingy? Once you've crossed the Sri Pok River, you're only about 45 clicks from Banlung. Chrome exhaust. Now he's wiring up the HT coil. Spanners are going clockwise now. New battery and a couple of new tyres, and it'll be brand new. Not forgetting, of course, that chain guard. Turns out the front bearings are shot. find an ATM and a nice cheap hotel room. Well, it doesn't look like the supermarket's open yet. Well, this place is completely unrecognisable from just 8 years ago. Ah, now I know where I am. This hasn't changed in 10 years. Well, after what's happened to me today, I think I deserve a little bit of pampering. Nothing from $20, only well above $20. Could be a little more down market. For the record, that was $5 a night. They were burning plastic fires right outside the rooms. I mean, well, this looks like a nice one, right next to a scrap metal dealership. I mean, that's not going to be too noisy, is it? Oh. Cold shower. Getting used to them. Windows on two sides. Alright. And there are even two drawers to put your clothes in, which you don't get in $80 rooms, as I've experienced. But it's Cambodian culture not to have the side light working. A coat hanger. Didn't get that in my $80 room. And of course, another obligatory part of the Cambodian culture is the feeblest internet imaginable. Wonder what I can eat in this town. And this bunch of retards here decided to have a bloody rave on the concrete drive right outside my hotel room. Freaking brilliant. Nothing jumps out at you at all. I mean, there's just nothing written in English. Well, this looks like the centre of barang activity, but this lovely lady here tells me the chef's not in, but if I just follow the road down, and look at that, treehouse. $2 to $8 with Wi-Fi, I mean. Ah, here we go, there's a sign in English. Well, French and Italian. Splendid. Oh yeah, that wouldn't hurt at all. Now that's what I'm talking about. I found some milk to go with my cereal in the morning. Another wonderful part of the culture is that the receptionist must listen to the TV so loud that it echoes all the way up to the next floor.